I'm here at the home of Peter Quillin, Kid Chocolate, one of the most talented young fighters out there. He's undefeated, and he's going to fight this weekend, co-headlining in Mexico, Pero Angulo, James Kirkland, Kid Chocolate against Craig McEwen. So first of all, your fight this weekend, tell me about it.
I'm super ready, fit, and ready to go, man. It's time to show the people why I've been working so hard to get to this point in my life.
Your opponent, very, very talented. I think he only has one loss, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
We saw him on HBO.
19-1.
Yeah. His last fight was on HBO.
Yes.
Against Lee from Ireland. And right, he was winning that fight, the whole fight.
So I want to ask you right now. I want you to be honest because I might be actually interviewing you right now, right? He's 19-1. What do you remember about his career?
That knockout.
So right now, he has a lot right now to ride off of. He got a knockout that he's coming off of would make him more probably more famous than any parts of his career. You know what I'm saying? So he got a lot of proving to do with this fight with Kid Chocolate like me. What's my record?
You're 28-0.
I'm 25-0.
25-0 with 19 knockouts.
19 knockouts. So he's 19-1, right? And I'm 25-0 with 19 knockouts. So I got more knockouts than the guy got fights.
Yeah, I've seen your last few fights. You ended them very early.
Yes.
They didn't go the distance.
Well, you know, that only comes with hard work in the gym. I don't take nothing less than hard work.
And what's going to happen in this fight, this weekend?
I'm going to beat him. That's it. You know, I can say that I can knock him out, but I let the critics and everybody else boxing people talk about that. And, you know, I just know that I'm training to win. That's what I'm training to do.
You were on the phone today with many, many reporters. What kind of questions did they ask you? Anything interesting?
Yes, Dan Raphael. I was on there with Dan Raphael and a couple other guys. I was just excited to be on the phone with Dan Raphael. That's cool, you know what I'm saying? But they were just saying, far as the injuries that I had and everything like that, you know, do I regret having it? No, I don't think no lost time is time that I lost, really. It's actually time in the sport that gave me more experience is what those injuries gave me. It gave me a little time set out to view where I'm at in my career. So I think, you know, the different things that they was asking me, I was prepared. You know, with every situation, I can't just look at it like, oh, it's new. I got to look and make myself believe that I was already at this point already. You know what I'm saying?
There you have it. Stay tuned.
Hey, hold on. But it's no different than interviewing with Eddie Setback, though. You know what I'm
saying? Oh, no, it's way different because I interviewed you from day one.
Yes.
They jump on the bandwagon 2 days before you're on HBO and you become super famous and popular. And then they're like, no, Dan Raphael, I have my own issues with them about, if I come out with a story, 5 minutes later, he tweets it, but without giving credit. But that's just my deal. Like, dude, don't be ashamed to say where you got your news from. It's all good.
But you know what, though? All publicity is good publicity.
Good publicity. There you have it.
By your name being in the mix, you know what I mean? You got to look at it like that, you know what I mean?
No, I'm good. I'm not complaining. I'm doing great. But we'll definitely watch you this weekend. Stay tuned. Kid Chocolate, Craig McEwen on HBO. You won't want to miss it. The fight's going down in Mexico. By the way, what people don't know is that you're fluent in Spanish. You're Cuban.
Yes.
Any message in Espanol for the fans in Mexico?
Yo tengo un mensaje por la toda la gente aquí en la boxeando. Yo practico mucho mi español porque yo sabe practicarse perfecto. But ese combate es el más bueno por mi career. Porque yo peleo por my father's country, Cuba. Yo peleo por, you know, America here. Es la todo cubano mirado la pelea on Saturday. You know what I'm saying? They're going to see why exactly I claim to be Cuban, as you can see. Mira la